Rainbow targets include an audio plugin export option. This gives you the ability to take your Rainbow Patcher and export it as a plugin for VST, AU, and Linux. This is regardless of what platform you're working from. Let's take a look at exporting our Rainbow Patch to a plugin. For demonstrating this plugin export target, we're going to use this simple Poly Synthesizer Rainbow Patch and we're going to export it as an instrument plugin. If you play a few notes, you can hear this Polyphony synth in action. You can also adjust the attack and release times by changing the numbers in the attribute UI objects. Double click on the Rainbow Tilter object and it will open in the Rainbow Patching environment. Here you can see two Param objects, one attached to the input for attack and one attached to the input for release of the ADSR Tilter object. Params are very important when it comes to targets. It ensures that when you export your Rainbow Patcher, that the controls you have set are exposed to the outside world. It also allows you to test the functionality of your Rainbow Patch in the top level Max Patcher. Let's export this patcher now. The plugin export sidebar will open. Here you can see all of the possible settings and options for our final exported plugin. The first option in the sidebar is the format and platform. You can choose VST3 for Mac, Windows or Linux, and AU for Mac. I'm going to select VST3 for Mac. Next is the name we would like to give to our plugin. I'm going to call it Simple Poly. And next up is the plugin manufacturer name. I'm going to add my company name here, Bees Knees. Then we have type. Let's leave this set as instrument, but you can also set it as effect when it's relevant to your patch. Output directory is our next option. By default, this is a folder in your documents. We typically leave it set to this, and then when it's built, we transfer it to our plugins folder. If you're doing a lot of rapid development, you might like to default this to go directly to your plugins folder or a more convenient location. And if you're working out of a project, the plugin will be exported back into that project. Next is include presets. If you made any snapshot presets for your Rainbow Patcher, toggling this box on will ensure that those presets are copied over when your patch is exported as a plugin. Let's make some quick presets so that we can see what that looks like when our plugin is exported. Back in the top level Max patch, change the attack and release values to something you like. Select the Rainbow Tilter object and then click on the snapshots icon in the right side toolbar. Click on New in the snapshot sidebar to set the current state as your preset. Once it's set, double click it to give it a unique name. Run through these steps two more times so that we have three new presets with unique names in total. Okay. Let's navigate back to our audio plugin export sidebar and double check include presets is toggled on. For further details on this, check out the parameters and presets video and article. Next we have package sample dependencies. This ensures that any buffer that includes a reference to an audio sample that is used inside of your Rainbow Patcher gets copied over as the plugin exports and builds, ensuring that the plugin works as expected once it's finished building. Next is Codegen Polyphony settings. There are three options here, linked, disabled, and voice count. Typically, if you have already set your Polyphony attribute, you'll want to leave linked selected. This ensures that your exported VST has the same number of voices as declared in the Rainbow object. However, for testing purposes or lower level control, you might want to disable polyphony entirely with the disable option, or override the voice count set in the patcher using the voice count option followed by the new total number of voices. Next is Codegen expose per voice parameters. We'll leave this unchecked for now, but this option allows you to control the parameters of each voice individually. And lastly, we have open export directory. If this is checked, your OS will automatically open the folder containing the exported plugin. We'll toggle this on so that we know when our export is finished. For further explanation on Polyphony, see the Polyphony video or article. Now we've filled out the export sidebar, let's export our plugin. Hit the icon in the bottom right corner, export to selected target. The export log window will be displayed, and here it runs through the steps as your plugin is compiled. All going well, you should see successfully exported target displayed in the export log, and then a folder containing your newly built plugins should pop up. Transfer your plugins to the default location for your machine. On Mac, that's going to be library, audio, plugins, and on Windows, it's going to be C drive, program files, common files. Providing these folders are correct, you can now open your preferred DAW and your newly built plugin should be available. Let's check out our new plugin in action. I'm going to open my DAW, Reaper, and I'm going to make a new virtual instrument. On first launch, after adding a new plugin to the file path, Reaper will show it initially under a new category in the All Plugins section. The next time you launch Reaper, it will be under the name of the plugin manufacturer or relevant type section. Let's play some MIDI in and we can hear our new plugin in action. You've now successfully built your own plugin out of Rainbow. For fun, try exporting more of the Rainbow examples. Happy patching!